Good morning, children. Welcome to the e-class of Deepal School, Baripada. Children, today is the first class after your first unit test. This is the moral sense class. Today I am going to take for class 5 students. This lesson what I am going to teach, this is lesson number 3, Never Make Comparison. Lesson number 3, Never Make Comparison. This is the lesson in your Happily Exam course. So, let's start the lesson, children. Lesson begins with, like human being, tree to feel good or bad about themselves, all of them think that the other one is better. The forest in the foothill of Himalaya have many small and big trees. They look greater. Like human being have this tendency to compare with other. Every human more or less thinks that he is somewhat better than other, or somebody have a negative feeling of themselves, the things they are inferior to other. This attitude also with the trees. This story tells us, the story begins with the foothill of Himalaya, means the northern plain of Himalaya, after the ground level of Himalaya. The trees there in the Himalayan region have this nature of comparing with each other. One day all the trees fell into an argument as to who was the best. The coconut tree said to the teak tree, I am very ugly and shapeless. I have a rough body full of scars. Now both the trees, coconut and teak, having a discussion. Coconut is saying to teak that I am a shapeless tree. I don't have a particular shape like you. My body also is not smooth like you. It is very rough. But how beautiful you look. You are so strong that no rain or sun, no cold can even harm you. No insect bore holes in your bark. Now coconut is saying to teak that you are so beautiful. You look so beautiful. Your structure is also very beautiful. No rain, no sun, no cold can harm you because you are so beautifully made by God. So even insect also cannot make hole in your trunk. So you are better than or better looking than me, the coconut tree told to the teak tree. In reply, the teak tree looked at the mango tree and said, coconut tree is amply praising me, but I admire your large, beautiful, sweet smelling, juicy fruits. You give a lot of other. Your fruits is called the king of fruit. I feel I am good at nothing. I am not as good looking as you. Now teak is comparing himself with mango tree. Now teak is saying to mango tree that coconut is simply praising me. I don't have that much quality what coconut tree is saying about me. Now teak tree is praising to mango tree that you are so beautiful. Your fruits are also called king of fruits. Mango is called king of fruits. So teak is saying to mango tree that your fruits are called king of fruits, and you give so much thing to people, but I, teak tree, never give anything to people. On listening to teak tree moment, the mango tree gave an envious look at the rose bush and said, now mango has some complex with of himself. Now mango is looking at the rose bush and said, means rose plant, I really envy you. Now mango tree is saying to rose plant, I really envy you. Envy means I feel what means if you think that somebody is better than you or good looking than you or having good quality than you, then you feel envious. Now mango tree feels envious of rose plant because rose is beautiful plant. It has beautiful colorful flowers. Every people love rose plant. So for that sake, mango plant is saying, your flowers are so colorful, sweet scented flower. You really look beautiful. The bees flock to you for honey. Men have to plant you in their home and garden. Many perfumes are made from your flowers, but teak tree is unnecessarily praising me. I have no flower and no scent. Now, mango plant is praising rose, and rose is also having negative feeling about itself, that mango plant is simply praising me, I don't have that much quality, I don't have flower like you, or neither my flower scents like you. So mango plant is praising rose, but rose also have negative thought about itself. Rose plant then looked at the neem tree and said, now rose plant is looking at the neem tree. You look fresh and pleasant to touch. Rose plant is saying that you look fresh and pleasant, means neem tree is looking beautiful and very good plant to touch. But rose plant is saying, but I am thorny, that my body is full of thorns. What shall I do with the beauty of flowers? Nobody like to touch me because they would not like to get hurt. Rose plant is saying to neem plant that nobody likes to touch me. They looks my beautiful but beautiful flower, but they never touch me because my entire body is full of thorns. So everybody is afraid that they will get hurt, so nobody touches me. Hearing this, the neem tree said, I am not as usual as the banyan tree, useful as the banyan tree. Now, neem tree also have inferior complex. He is saying, I am not also good looking as a banyan tree or having good quality as banyan tree. It looks at the banyan tree and said, you are a really strong tree. You are so large, no one can figure out where your root and end and where your branches. Now neem tree is praising banyan tree. As you children know, banyan tree is having a special quality, hanging roots. The roots are generally hangs from the branches. These roots give strength to the banyan tree. So neem tree is praising the banyan tree that your roots are so big and huge that nobody can know which is your root and which is your trunk. It looks same and it makes give you so much strength. Being every root as well as branch is so tough and yet so supple. It can easily be bent but cannot be broken. But look at my branches, how easily they break off, causing me pain and sorrow. Now neem tree is saying to banyan tree that your branches are so flexible and so strong, nobody can break your branches, but my branches are so soft. Neem tree is saying my branches are so soft that easily anybody can break. So breaking my branches caused me pain and sorrow. Because one after another people goes on breaking my branches. It is a painful thing for me and I am very sad. Sorrow means sad that I am losing my branches. But nobody can break your branch because they are very strong. Neem tree is saying to the banyan tree. Banyan tree then turned towards the bubble tree and said, how useful your branches are. Your trunk is used for firewood. Now, banyan tree is praising the bubble tree. Bubble tree are generally found in desert area, thorny plants full of thorns. Their trunks are generally used for firewood, burning, used by people for cooking. Your burns quickly and provide an inexpensive and easy fuel for the poor needy people. Now, banyan tree is saying to the thorny plant, bubble tree, that your branches and twigs are so nice that easily they can be burned by the poor people. They use generally for fuel. So bubble tree then had a look at the people tree and said, your branches look so wonderful. You have rich foliage. All the passerby rest in your shade. Many beautiful birds come and sit in you, but I am just a cluster of thorny bushes and rugged, skinny trunk. I bear no fruit. I cannot even give shade to anybody. I feel so neglected. Now, bubble tree then had to look at the people tree. Now, bubble tree is looking at the people tree and saying that people tree, actually very big tree, shady tree, full of leaves. So the bubble tree is saying to the people tree that you are having so beautiful branches full of leaves. They give shade, so every passerby, whoever passes the way on that way, try to sit under your shade and try to take rest. Even birds and animals also come under you to take rest. I cannot give shade to anybody because bubble tree leaves are too small. They never create any shade under them, so nobody sit under bubble tree. So bubble tree is feeling very sad that nobody sit under my shade because my leaves are so small that it does not create any shade for anybody else. So nobody likes to sit under bubble tree. The people tree looked at the coconut tree and said, you look so tall and straight. You sway your body and offer your refreshing and nourishing fruits. Now, people tree is praising coconut tree. The people tree is saying that your fruits are so refreshing and nourishing that every people likes to drink the coconut juice. Feel so small in front of you that people tree is feeling very small. He is saying that people tree is saying that I feel very small in front of you because you give so much energetic fruit juice as well as coconut to eat to others, but people tree don't give any fruit to eat. So I have nothing else to offer other than leaves. Only people take my leaves, no fruits, because people tree doesn't have any fruit. You are so generous and productive, but I do not bear my fruit, any fruit. Now people tree saying to coconut that you are so generous, people loves coconut tree because they can drink coconut, tender coconut juice as well as coconut, but people tree cannot give any fruit to anybody else. In this way, all the trees thought that the other one was better. God has gifted us all with same exceptional quality, which other do not have. Now, in this story, we are seeing that every tree is thinking other tree to be better than it. So, every tree is thinking that I am being neglected by God, or I don't have that much quality what others have, but they forget that everybody or every small or big living creature is created by God. God will not let you down. Whatever good qualities is with you, God has given. It is up to you to find out the qualities within you. always comparing with other is not good. We should thank God for the qualities He has given us. We should be content with what we have and should never be jealous of someone else's good qualities. Now, whatever good qualities we have to find out in our lifetime. It is we have to search what God has given. God has given us ample of good qualities in us. It is our job to find out what we have. Instead of doing so, we think other to be more gifted by God and we being neglected by God. It is not right. We should not feel jealous or envious of others' quality. We should always feel proud of what qualities we have. This story teaches us that thinking always inferior in front of others is not good. Always think that I am better than other, I have more quality than other, because all these things are given by God. So God always give what we want. God has given us what we want in our life. It is up to us to find out what we have. This is the story, and the moral of the story is, do not compare yourself with others. Be content with what you have received. Means, please don't compare yourself with others. This is very bad thing of comparing with others. What you have, happy with that. What the other have, let them enjoy their life with that. You don't feel neglected or deprived of the good quality what others have. You don't know God has given more than them, but it is up to you to look at the way or you have to change your look, how you're looking about yourself, your life. Be satisfied. Be content means be satisfied with what you have received from God. So always feeling jealous of others is not good. Then your life will become hell. You cannot get peace and happiness in your life. You can get peace and happiness and have a successful life if you content what you have, because God has given those things. Thinking that, always think positive about your life, about your journey. Then only you will successful in future. Good story with good message, children. Thank you, children, for watching this video. So, till we meet again with other story, bye-bye.